and the anti-establishment protests, to give them probably the most accurate description, grew over the weekend. It began, we think, as an outcry against rising prices and tough economic times, but it's become a little bit broader than that. Let's speak now to Iranian analyst Holly Dagres. She's an Iranian-American analyst, and she's behind the weekly newsletter The Iranist. Holly, welcome to the programme. In terms of the response from the government, were you expecting them to be harsher?
I was a little bit surprised, to be honest. It was, I thought, a bit of a departure from President Mohammad Khatami's speech during the 1999 student uprisings. But at the same time, he did hit the same points, which is you have a right to protest, but please don't destruct Iranian property. So I was expecting more of a harsh come down and more of a blame of the protesters. But I think that's not really the job of the president to do. I think it'll be interesting to see what the Supreme Leader, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, will be saying this Friday during his Friday prayer sermon. Mm-hmm.
And in terms of what, I mean, as far as we know, the information that obviously you're following, as far as it comes out of Iran, there doesn't appear to be any central organization. This isn't prompted, like, for example, the so-called Green Revolution by a sort of a contested election. This is, what is it? It's casual, it's bitty, it's diffused. It doesn't seem led by anyone or any one organization, does it?
Well, it's a bit complicated. So on Thursday, hardliners in this holy city of Mashhad led a protest against Rouhani. And as you may or may not know, they are a very anti-Iran deal and dealings with the West in general and want to keep to the tradition of what is the Velayat-e Faqih, the Islamic Republic.
So these are conservatives. So this begins as a conservative protest there.
Yes, it began as a conservative protest, and it essentially was this controlled burn that they were doing, and it kind of spread into a wildfire that they can't control, because now you've got cities and provinces that are protesting. And what really differentiates this from 2009 and now, of course, them being two different reasons, as you said, it's leaderless. There are people taking the streets in provinces and towns that we did not even see in 2009. And while these numbers aren't as big, like you're not getting a million people in Azadi Square, in Tehran's main square, you're getting a lot of Iranians that are actually going to the street in places we hadn't heard of protests before. And that's what really makes this a bigger deal, in my opinion.
And not being sort of within any sort of politically organized form of protest, where does this go? Doesn't it just fizzle out? I mean, maybe that accounts for why the government isn't cracking down too hard, because they know that ultimately this will just dissipate, won't it, realistically?
Absolutely. You're absolutely correct when you're saying that. When you have a leaderless movement, it has the ability definitely to fizzle out. And given the history of Iranian protests, and this is something that's been going on since the early 20th century, it's under the Qajars, under the Mohammad Reza Pahlavi regime, under the current regime, you have this history of protests. And I would say it eventually will fizzle out. And if it doesn't, unfortunately, they're going to have to crack down like they normally will. So I think it's wrong to interpret this as something long term, or in some people saying this is a second coming of the revolution. This is something that a lot of people are angry. They have economic grievances. They have anger about the corruption in the country. And they're very much fed up with a lot of the promises that were made during the 1979 revolution. And this new generation of Iranians, these are the children of the revolution, are now in their 30s and their 40s. And they're really just thinking about their families at this point. And for them, they want to see change in the country. So I know a lot of people are kind of saber-rattling that this is going to be regime change in Iran, those that are in the West. But I think that's unrealistic to assume. And this is more of a economic and corruption, anger against corruption.
Sure.
And it's evident from a lot of the chants you've been hearing.
Many thanks indeed. Holly Dagres, Iranian-American analyst. She's behind the newsletter The Iranist.
Now, China is the world leader in many fields.